Welcome back to PGA Chain Design. Today's topic, we are going to talk about how to do this wire freeform ring and fitting into this dome shape. Are you ready? Let's get started. To start our ring, we're gonna start at the front view that set the diameter for 16mm. Then we wanna come into the right view to set up our profile for the dome. The one on the top, I'm going to snap into the quadrant, and I want to make it a little bit wider, so maybe something like this, roughly about 10mm wide. If it is too tall, you can adjust the height if you want to, and then let me close it over here. The other one, we could just mirror this one, or we can draw another one, but I'm just gonna mirror it to the other side. And make sure that you want to use the scale to 3D tool to scale it down, something like that. Okay, watch out the thickness. You don't want it to be too thin, otherwise you may have a casting issue or it's changing too dramatic. Let's go ahead to join both of the arc and the line together. And then we are going to making the surface. Let's do the sweep one rail. This is your rail, go from here to here and then hit enter. Normally I will have it right in the middle because that's where the seam is, and so we're just gonna keep like that. And then we want to also close the sweep to get our dome ring first. So this is the dome ring, and then we need to have an opening. Now we need to find the edge for the thickness that we like for those two walls on the side. So we're gonna extract ISO curve. And then it's gonna pick up this surface, and I'm kind of eyeballing where I want this ring to be cut. All right, so we don't wanna do the same thing on the other side. Best way to do is just mirror to the other side on the top view. All right, so now let's hide the dome ring. And when we are looking at those, let's draw a curve, a straight line from the middle, and we simply just want to use a line, move up a little bit, and to trim the area that we don't want it, which is on the bottom. So now we have this two showing the thickness of the boulder, and we are going to connect this button to be a round one. And then so let's go ahead to use the blend tool, and we're gonna blend from this end to that end, and then we're gonna blend it again from this end to that end. I didn't adjust the lenses because I want to make sure both sides the same, so I'll rather adjust the curve instead of adjust the length individually. Alright, so now we have this. Let's turn on our ring. This curve is not exactly on top of it. Where the blend is, it's not exactly on top of the surface. So what we wanted to do is using the pull command, and we're gonna pull this curve back to this surface. And you can see now it is on the surface. We're gonna make a copy of the ring and then just hide it just in case we need it later. And then we are going to split this surface by the curve over there. Let me turn in other colors so now you can see where that curve is. So now we have the surface that we are going to work. So I want to offset the surface going in a little bit. My wire is going to be 0.6mm in diameter. So I'm going to flip it inside for 0.6mm, and make sure solid equal no, and we want to creating a surface. So let's hide this one. This will be the surface that we wanted to our curve to hop on it. So we also gonna hide this one to deal with this surface only. The way I'm going to do is draw a bunch of the curve. Or straight line. And you can be spontaneous, or you can be like really into certain pattern. You might not want to have a too many. So once you have the piping, it won't look like too crowded. So let's give it a try. We want to project this guy to this surface. Notice that because this is a projection somewhere on the side, you can kind of see this is getting more rounded instead of a straight line that we like. And if you pipe this guy, let's give it a try. then you will get something like this. If that is something that you like, that's fine. You can go ahead and finish that. But I'm going to show you the second way to work with this. The second way we want to create UV curve. So then we have a UV curve over there. And I'm going to use exactly the same curve, maybe stretch a little bit for the comparison. And we are going to use this curve to trim everything else that is not inside of that area. Okay, so now this is our curve over there. Watch out this point, it may have the problem on the piping, so I'm just gonna move it outside and trim it again. And make sure you don't have anything hanging inside, otherwise we'll see the end of the piping. Alright, so that's making this into a surface by a surface from planar curve. And then we want to move it this back to that surface. So we need to bring back the rest of the ring and let's give it a try. We want to do a flow along the curve and then we want to pick up this end. We want to come into the bottom and pick up this end. So that way that will hop on the surface. Notice that it's not the surface that we wanted to hop on. We want to actually go down a little bit. In this case, I'm going to move this down minus 0.6. So that way that will be hopping on the surface over there. So let's do one more time. Flow along the surface. And then we want to go base over here and clicking on over here. So let's turn off the ring and you kind of see this is hopping on the surface really nice. So let's give it a try. We want to pipe it and see what piping look like. Also, you can notice that the line is still keep it straight looking. So it's not on the like a project, it will kind of curve it. So we'll go ahead to use the pipe and then want to set it up the same radius and that will be the ring that we have. So let's bring back the rest of the ring. We also need to make sure the surface in between is closed. First, let's duplicate the edges, go all the way around this guy. And also the edges from here all the way around. So we can have a perfect fit when we, and let's join it. And so now it leaves us two curves. I just mark it in the red color. And then we can use the loft tool and we're gonna loft from here to here. We want to seem to be aligned. I usually like to align to the tip of the circle or the quadrant or the midpoint over there. And let's click enter. Then we'll get the very nice surface there. We can kind of join it and we can turn it on the curve that we have. You can also punch it through all the way to the end, like what I have. So when you punch through all the way to the end, just make sure that the loft is going from inside of a ring shank to top of the ring. And then you can do double of the same style, then you will get this hollow form. I need your help to ask all your friends and relatives and cousins and anybody to subscribe it so I can reach 30,000 subscribers earlier in order to open the membership feature. I hope you enjoyed the video. Please like and comment and share my video. Thank you and I will see you next.